Over the last decade or so, one of the major differentiators for technology companies has been a relentless product focus on customer experience or end user experience. What we're beginning to see now is the same type of approach being brought in-house to focus on developers, who are now the new customers of a whole new breed of software products.
The breadth of responsibilities of software engineers are expanding, while attracting and retaining good engineering talent remains a challenge. All of these factors have contributed to a focus on improving the developer's experience.
We're already seeing the companies we work with start to judge software and offerings and cloud products based on the amount of developer friction that they reduce, or in some cases, the amount of friction they introduce. Developer experience is equally important for internal infrastructure.
Thoughtworks has historically championed picking tools that are really good to use that focus on developer experience. In many ways, part of the Thoughtworks technology radar has been looking at our view of which tools make teams more effective.
There's a real tension here for most organizations. For years, developers have been written off as complaining about anything that got in their way. But really what you're seeing is when it takes lots of tickets to get something deployed into production, when developers are waiting on a shared test environment before they can put their changes through. Those are real efficiency problems that are causing a lack of throughput for the organization.
API as a product is an interesting technique that keeps evolving. Today's applications and services are built by interconnecting a network of APIs. The developers are the users of those APIs. So using user experience techniques like usability testing and user research to API development ensures it to be a joy to be used.
Sabemos que trabajar con sistemas legados puede ser una de las experiencias más retadoras, conflictivas y desafiantes que un desarrollador puede enfrentar al momento de crear productos que dependen de estos. Sin embargo, estamos viendo temas como legado en una caja, donde los desarrolladores están creando imágenes virtuales de estos sistemas o incluso contenedores Docker que permiten al desarrollador correr todos estos ambientes en un ambiente local o de pruebas sin la necesidad de compartir un solo ambiente entre todos, evitando problemas de sincronización, por ejemplo, en donde los desarrolladores ahora con estas nuevas imágenes pueden tener un entorno más seguro para hacer sus cosas, un entorno más fiable, un entorno más agradable, mejorando todo esto la experiencia de este desarrollador para crear estos nuevos productos, para crear las nuevas capacidades.
Some of the key things to think about there is some empathy for who's going to be using your product. You've got to get into the headspace of the people who are using it. And for us, this is really what it means to think about your API or your service or your infrastructure as a product. It's you have a long-lived roadmap where you're gaining feedback from your end users, you're integrating that back into your roadmap, and you're adjusting and improving your product as you go.
Netflix has been an industry leader in creating platform capabilities for developers to do amazing work efficiently. ADRIAN COCKCROFT, then the director of engineering at Netflix, during one of his talks was questioned by a Fortune 100 company CTO that those ideas are great, but they won't work for us. Netflix has superstar development team and we don't. To which he replied, you did have those people. We hired them from you and we got out of their way.
Developers intrinsically want to deliver value and they want to deliver it fast. IT organizations need to invest in clearing obstacles and getting out of their way and allowing developers to do what they're best at, delivering kick-ass software.